Good morning, everyone. Thank you for having me today. Let me introduce myself. My name is Hari Mahardika, but yeah, maybe you call me Harry because it's hard to spell Hari. I'm from HOT. Specifically, I'm from a representative from Indonesia. So if you know Indonesia, it's close to Singapore. Yeah, yes. And all of you know Singapore, yeah. Or if you know Bali, yeah, Bali is one of the island in Indonesia. So it's a beautiful country. So today I will going to present about one of our big project in Indonesia. It's so I give the title OSM for Disaster Management Citywide Mapping Project. In this presentation, I have five outlines that I will present to you. The first outline is what? It's I will tell you about the general about the project, what our aim to do in this project. And the second one is when the project started, when it's finished in each city. So we map three big cities in Indonesia, Surabaya, Jakarta, and Semarang. So I will tell you when the mapping in each city started and finished. And the third outline is how. This is more like a tell you about how we do the whole activities in this project. Start from the pre-mapping activities until it's post-mapping activities. And the fourth outlines is the most important thing, the result, the impact of the people. And the fifth outline is challenge and what we learn from this project, especially in our country. So yeah, this is a program, a joint program with the PDC, or Pacific Disaster Center, from University of Hawaii. And also with our Indonesia National Disaster Management Agency and MIT and Humanitarian OpenStreetMap to support disaster management tools and data for Indonesia. How we can support the disaster management tools and the data for Indonesia? By provide an accurate up-to-date map in the OSM for the city of Surabaya, Jakarta, and Semarang. So this is the general aim of this project. And then, yeah, the mapping project are, generally we map anything in the city. So yeah, we map start from the banks until the administration boundary and also gas station, everything including the green spaces, because the green spaces in the city can be used for the evacuation shelter when the disaster happens. So it's kind of important object as well. And also the education facility, health facilities. And we didn't only mapping the position of the object, but we also including the important information for each object, such as building function and when emergency situation happened, and the building structure, wall type, building levels, roof type, and building condition. So all this information can be very useful for a disaster management agency. And also we collected the natural physical object such as river, lake, and dam, and green field. So when the mapping project started in each city, so the first city is Surabaya. It was started in October 2016 and finished in February 2017. So it's like a 5 months mapping. And the second city is Jakarta. This is maybe the famous city among the others, starting from March until November 2017. So 7 months. And the last city, or the third city, is Semarang. It started January and just finished in July 2018. So all the cities located in Java Island. So how we do the all activities in this project? So yeah, I will talk about the pre-mapping activities first. The first, because in Indonesia it's really important to government or the local government know how you do your mapping project, so we have to meet doing initial meeting with them. And our aims is first to getting the surveying permit letter. This is a very important document in Indonesia, because if our team only introduce, hello, we are from HOT, we're doing some mapping for disaster, the people or the local government won't believe you. You will be seen as a bad people or terrorist if you mapping around their area without permission, something like that. So this is the document is very important to show the people we have recognized by the local government. So this is the first aim. The second aim, why we started the initial meeting before we start mapping, to get the what actually object that they really need. Each city has a different kind of situation and needs for information. For example, in Jakarta, you don't have to mapping the small place of worship, small mosque, because small mosque usually doesn't use as a evacuation shelter if disaster happen. But in Semarang, in our third city, even the small mosque also will be used as an evacuation shelter. So a different preference for the object, it's also important for us to know before doing mapping activities. And the second thing, this is important to building a community. So what we are going to do, so we hire and train local people. So we did hire a people, we paid them, not really voluntary action, but we hire local people. Why local people? Because the local people is really full of knowledge of the city. So this is really important, because if we hire just someone who really likes mapping in OSM or only interested in this project, but doesn't really know the city, you will be stuck to find the area when you're mapping. So local people won't be get lost. So it's save time to do the mapping activities. And we train them, so we train local people how to using OSM. So our requirement you have to know OSM before you join with us, no. Because it's our really special, but our one of requirement is they know how to use computer and internet, that's it. And they're interesting to do some humanitarian activity. And the second one is to contact local university. Why local university? Because we think in Indonesia it's better to start with the academic institution. Why? Because they have a lot of younger student who interested about the innovation. So OSM in Indonesia is seen as an innovation, because a lot of spatial data is really hard to find, especially in a rural area. So OpenStreetMap is the best alternative for them. And the third action is initiate local mapathon with the local university. So from this, we also teach them how to use OSM generally and tasking manager and doing local mapathon. Why we doing local mapathon? Because we want to collect the building footprint first and the roads for access for our team to do the survey. And the third is mapping equipments, survey map. So this is a map that our team bring to the field. And the satellite imagery, we got the satellite imagery from the USID, the update one. But still has a problem, because Indonesia is in a tropical area, so it's a lot of clouds covered the area. Sometimes the resolution is not really good, but yeah. And just some setting, we have edited some text, so we have a special tag for this, because we need a special information. We cannot use a default JOSM tag, so we have to make a new one for this project. And the mapping team structures. So we have in each city, we have two mapping supervisor. So this is the high position to keep the mapping activity still on the track. And four quality assurance. So the quality assurance is responsible for the data quality. We don't want to just collecting a lot of data in the field, but also make sure the quality is good enough to use by the local government and the people. And the 16 data entry, we call it mapper in the field. So for Surabaya and Semarang, we have a 16 data entry. About Jakarta, because the area is bigger than the rest, so we still have a two mapping supervisor, but we have five quality assurance. and we add the data entry up to 20 people. And how about the structure? This is the mapping team structure. So it's a team supervisor, supervise like a two quality assurance or QA, and each QA will supervise like a four data entry in the field. So it's like a two times filtering for the data quality. So yeah, we also doing some like a mapping strategies. So we divided the team. One team consists of only two people. Why two people? Because we can spread a lot of people in a lot of area at the same time. And also, if you don't have only a lot of head, there is no lot of drama or problems because only two people will discuss, not many people. It's saving your time. We don't want to drama in this project. And a solid group. Why I can say solid? Because we mix about the new user and the experienced user. So the new user, usually coming from local people, is they really know the area, and the experienced user, they will teach the new user how to use the OSM and digitize. So it's like a mixed knowledge. And regionalize the city. So it's depend on the orientation of the size of the area. For like example, Surabaya and Semarang, it's more landscape. So we divide it into north and the south part. For what? For to help mapping supervisor to focus for its area or its zone. And for Jakarta, because its orientation, it's more portrait, so we have east and west. And we also doing always regular team evaluations, starting from small team evaluation, QA evaluation, and the whole team evaluation. We did it in once a month. And mobile technology approach, so we using ODK, Open Data Kit, and Open Map Kit as a tools to doing mapping activities. And for you who didn't know about the ODK, it's like a apps that can help you to collecting data in the field. And OMK is an extension of the ODK. So it's integrated with OpenStreetMap. So once you have a building footprint in your survey area, you just can click the building and fill the information on it. It's saving a lot of time for this project. And this is mapping activities. I will make a weird animation, so yeah, to explain with you. So yeah, start from the office or data entry using motorcycle, bring the survey permit letter from the local government and survey map. The first stop is village office, asking permission, like, sir, in the next 2 or 3 days, you will always see us around your area to map. So we asking your permission and update the administrative boundary up to sub-village level. And after that, after our DA give the permission from the village office, they continue to survey all the critical objects. They use Open Data Kit and Open Map Kit. And after that, they tired and they went back to the office. Yeah, still waiting, sorry. And after they arrive in the office, yeah, this is the next phase of the mapping activities. The DA or data entry input all the survey data using JOSM and upload it to the server. And after that, the quality assurance download the data and check its quality, both in topology, like crossing buildings and connected ways, or the information that we need to be reviewed. And after that, the mapping supervisor will export the data and give it back to the DA to make village map and printed them and distributed them to the village office. So we give the printed map to the village office as our appreciation for them. And post-mapping activities, so we create atlas for each city. So all the printed map we combine into one books and create the atlas for the city. It's kind of help the government. And we also know about after this project finish, we have to make sure the local community and local government preserve all the data that have been collected in the field. So we're doing workshop for local government and university. It's more like using OSM in the basic, but it's more like how to validate the data and make sure the quality is not changed or still good. And make training modules and documentation to inspire other community and also to make sure if they forget how the steps, they can have a guide. The result, yeah, so this is the result for three cities. Surabaya finished in 3 months, and Jakarta 5 months, and Semarang 4 months. As you can see, the map changed in my slide. I taken from the visualization tools change from HOT. It's like a new visualization, new tools to see the change when you start before you map and after you map. So it's kind of help to spread the progress of your activities. And then, yeah, a lot of data we collected. I won't mention one by one, but yeah, a lot of data you can see in the map change. And this is the survey map, actually. So this is the map that we bring to the village office before we started the map. And after that, this is the after we finish the survey. So it's really helped the people to get all the information. And we also make a thematic map for the government and the village office. For example, there were two maps. The first one in Jakarta, it's evacuation and road shelter maps. And the second one is hazard map for the Semarang city. So we also make for them. And data use, our OSM data also used by the Peta Bencana. It's like a social media platform. So you can report live the flood or the fire hazard using your smartphone, and they will use our OSM data, especially in administrative boundary. This is the from PDC. So Pacific Disaster Center created a tools for our National Disaster Management Agency called InAware. It's like a platform that combine all the data from all the agencies, mixed from the government agency and private agency, and OSM, our data will be used as one of the layer in these tools. The challenge, sometimes we also rejected by people and village, even though we have a local permit letter from the BPB local government. If this happened, we asked the local disaster management agency to escort us to the field. So they make sure they really believe that we're working with the government, not for any other things. And area condition, this is not unexpected. We experience like a small landslide in Semarang when we survey. So it's like a, yeah, delayed our mapping time. And traffic condition, yeah, especially in Jakarta, it's really hard for like a 5 kilometer distance. It's the traffic, you can reach by 1 hour. Or 1.5 hours, so it's really bad traffic condition. So that's why we're using motorcycle, not cars. And the weather, we only have two seasons, rainy season and summer. So yeah. And if we're using motorcycle, we have to pull up. And unexpected event, we hit by car and flat tire. It's a regular situation sometimes for our team. So, but we can overcome it. Lesson learned. Availability of exposure data is critical in Indonesia. So this mapping project should be replicated in other cities, especially in disaster prone area. As you know, maybe you have read about the recent days, our country just hit by the earthquake and followed by tsunami in Sulawesi. So it's like a very important to prepare all the data before we doing the response. And from our side, I think it's really good for government and community could and should working together to create a good and reliable base map and up-to-date information. Government needs community, and community also needs government, because with the support from the government, the community can be more effective to doing their programs, I think. OpenStreetMap can be a very good alternative to gather all the information and provide a base map for community and government, particularly in disaster management system for this project. So yeah, before I finish, I will play some videos. This video is from Semarang City, but I hope it will give you image for what we are going. Okay. Yep. Sorry.
Same shirt as today.
Yeah, that's the video. Hope can give you a lot of insight about our project. And yeah, I think this is the last of my presentation. So the rest of the my slide, it's only picture of Indonesia. So if you have a time, please come to our country. It's a beautiful country. Please ask Stephen Johnson if you don't believe me. And yeah, thank you for your cooperation and attention. Yeah, maybe we have some time to give doing some Q&A session. If you have any, please let me know. Yes? So the future of HUT in Indonesia, it's actually with still trying to reach local community in its lot of areas, because sometimes we have this is the big one project that we did in Indonesia, but we also have a side project like from Grab. Grab, it's like a Uber transport apps, like a Uber, and they want to try to use OSM as well, and they want to doing like a university battle mapping, we call it. It's like a competition using OSM. So it tried to reach community by some of our programs. And for this project, we are working now to create Atlas for Jakarta and Semarang, because the Atlas that just finished is only for Surabaya. It takes time. So yeah. Yeah, please. Sama-sama. I'm sorry, I cannot hear you. Oh, so this project is funded by the USAID. And how much, I cannot tell you because it's my country manager who know all the total of the project, but it's quite a lot of funding because we map three cities, three big cities. Yeah, right now we have Indonesia, we have two big projects. Now my project is PDC, and the second one it's from Facebook, like a Dristi tell you yesterday. So that's the two biggest project, but we also have a side project with the local NGO and also the local company. But we always use OSM, and all our object, our data, it's always uploaded to the OSM. We always tell our partner, your data will be uploaded to the OSM. Your data will be public domain, so yeah. Anyone? Oh, sir, sorry.
Do you see opportunities to co-evolve with the Facebook project? Obviously, they're very different, but machines and humans, you have to find a way to get along.
Yeah, yeah, I know a lot about the details about the Facebook project. So yeah, the Facebook, it's created a machine learning to identify the roads using the satellite imagery, and the people that we in our offices try to validate the data. Like some of the roads, it's still unconnected, so they try to connect the roads, and the classification of the roads, it's also need to done by a human, something like that. Yeah. Anything? So yeah, if you have additional question, you can ask me personally. I will be around here until tomorrow. Yeah, of course, tomorrow. So yeah, thank you again for your attention, and good morning.